He works in yeshiva in Zazel, and he's not officially part of Chabad Noam.
Maar spier, wat ben
je? Wie is jij? Wat is dat?
Haak in die loop, onze zon is wat een simpel van Sidim. Ik ben going to tell over a story which is fairly well known, Bestama, but it doesn't hurt to repeat it. And the story obviously has a shaykhus with Chal in this moment we're in now, and also has a shaykhus with Pasha Vayichi. Maisa, I heard, I'm going to tell the nusach that I heard from Rameh Abson. There are maybe other nusachos and other details which change, but the Chal is chuvim is emes. Maisa goes back to the time when the Rebbe first became the son-in-law of the Friedrich Rebbe, or was about to become the son-in-law of the Friedrich Rebbe. And I don't know where it took place, but it was a time that Levitchi Masmig was taking part in the Fabregen by the Friedrich Rebbe. And it was by he, after a few lachaims, and Levitchi Masmig decided that he wanted to tell something to the Friedrich Rebbe. So he says to the Friedrich Rebbe, Rebbe Girl Tzedek, I want to tell you a story. That's how he used to refer to the Friedrich Rebbe. So the Friedrich Rebbe says, Sue, hold on a minute. Then came the next interval, and he took another lachaim, it seems, in between. And again he said, Rebbe Girl Tzedek, I want to tell you a story. An important story is negated to you. And again the Friedrich Rebbe told him to hold on a minute. At some point later, the Rebbe walks in. The young, new young Aiden walks in, and immediately the Friedrich Rebbe made sure there should be a space. And once the Rebbe was standing there, then the Friedrich Rebbe looks to the direction of the Levitchi Masmig and he says to him, Nu, now tell the story. The problem was, by that time, he had already taken too many lachaims, and it was not possible for him to tell the story. So the Chassidim saw something strange is going on. There's a Samaisa and Snegir to the Friedrich Rebbe. And after when the Rebbe walks in, now he can tell the story, it must be something very important. So they decided to ask him after. So the next day, or whenever the next opportunity was, they asked him to tell the story. He didn't want to say the story. So they knew the Rebbe to work this one out. It's another bottle of mashke, but to measure it the right amount, not too much, not too little. And finally, they managed to get him to tell the story. And the story occurs after the Matzah Shabbos. It starts out in the times of the Mezitcher Magid. We know that the Mezitcher Magid would sometimes, first of all, he would have a shomer, a mesharis, that would guard, it would be next to him while he was sleeping. So this mesharis had to either a mishnayis or zayah, maybe the two mesharis in Akopana. We know from one famous story that the Alter Rebbe was zeicher to Perek Lamed Beis of Tanya due to this. Mesharis, who at that time, the Geta Pentagon Beis of Tanya, was a very American gents. He was about one night, he was by the market, and the market occasionally would wake up and say something, a gilui. So one night, for example, he woke up and he said, Hes melech was meret in the sifti drakia, memuz lipom na roshagom azev yatsadigom. And when this was told to Rebbe Melech, he later on told it over to the Alter Rebbe, and therefore it was added in Pentagon Beis of Tanya. So one of these nights, somebody else must have been in the Mesharis, whoever it was, and the Magid one in the middle of the sleep wakes up and he says, Mashiach is going to be from one of my Talmidim, either from the oldest or from the youngest. So this message got around the Talmidim, and at some point, I don't know when, the Alter Rebbe decided to do something about it. The Alter Rebbe was the youngest Talmid, and Reb Nochem, I think it was Reb Nochem Shenobula, Reb Nochem was the father, if I'm not mistaken, Reb Motel was the son. So Reb Nochem, Shenobula, Reb Nochem, the oldest Talmud, and the Alter Rebbe was the youngest Talmud. So at some point, the Alter Rebbe, when the story reached his ears, at some point he decided he's going to do something about it. So he decided he's going to discuss it. As far as I know, he discussed it after the Estalkus of Reb Nochem. So the next Rebbe was Reb Motel, Shenobula. So he decided he's going to make his way to Chernobyl and work things out. What's the best way to work it out? well, if it's from the oldest Talmud and from the youngest Talmud, which is the Chernobyl or the Alter Rebbe, if you make a shidduch between the two families, something's going to happen. So work it out that way. So he decided to go over to the Motel, and he went there, like he says, for Shabbos, he went there. And once of Shabbos, he went with a walk, for a walk with the Motel to discuss the Inyan. Where did they go walking? The meaning is, Matzah Shabbos, you go shepin vaser, you go to draw water. Why do you draw water Matzah Shabbos? It's brought down that Matzah Shabbos, the Be'erus Shel Miriam, is mispashit in all the Be'erus, in all the Nahoris. Just a simple text, simple, just in order to understand what it means, Be'erus Shel Miriam, there is a small simple about the Arizal. The Arizal had this famous Talmud, Reb Chaim Vital. Reb Chaim Vital, when he first started learning by the Arizal, he complained to the Arizal that he doesn't really understand what is too high. So the Arizal said, come with me, I'm going to deal with this. He takes him on a little boat, and they go to the Yam Kinneret with a cup. And the Arizal takes out in the middle, somewhere over there, in the middle of the Yam, he takes a cup of water and he gives it to Reb Chaim Vital to drink. He drank up the water and he said, now you'll understand what I'm talking about. You just drank from Be'erus Shel Miriam. This gives us a little bit of an insight into the type of people who are the Yates and Mitzrayim, why they're called the Dor HaDeah. They had, for breakfast and for supper, they had the Be'erus Shel Miriam. So if from one cup the Reb Chaim Vital was able to understand all Kisvei Arizal, can you imagine what they understood when they had every day Be'erus Shel Miriam, plus the mon, Levitna Teirel, so the Yates and Mitzrayim, those people who have the mon and the Be'erus Shel Miriam. Al-Kopon, this is the Be'erus Shel Miriam. So the minute Tzadikim is they go out of town and they shep vaser in order to drink some water from Be'erus Shel Miriam. Maybe they'll be zeicher to have a little bit of that water. So that's what happened. They went out and they're standing there by the well. Reb Nachum's got a bucket over his shoulder. And they're going to shep vaser. And they're having a discussion. And this is going on for hours. They're discussing Yanim Ma'im to Berum Shalayim. And at some point, finally, the Alter Rebbe came to the point why he came for the visit. He wants to take one of Reb Nachum's Einiklach, which is a Motel's sons, or Einiklach, for his Einiklach. The Mittler Rebbe had a daughter, and he decided he's going to find a shidduch from the Chernobyl Einiklach. So this is what he was discussing. So finally, the way it was described to me, that there was a very interesting scene. You see the older Motel standing there, and another young man, which nobody knew who he was, was the Alter Rebbe, and they're standing there talking with a bucket over their shoulders. It was already getting light. Finally, they decided, okay, we're going to go home now, it's getting early in the morning, and they went back to the house, and they have to choose a shidduch for the daughter of the Mittler Rebbe. Okay, so they go in, and the children are still sleeping, they're all babies. And they're picking out which child is going to be the right one. So according to the way the nusach I heard, the Alter Rebbe went over to the children and started measuring their heads. He was measuring to see the size of the head. So when he decided, he finally picked on one child, he said, this is the one I want. This one. Okay, Ogered, this is the one. Later came along, some point later, when this child grew up, he was really very smart boy, and at one point, the Baruch of Medrash came to town, and he met this boy. And when he met him, he saw who he was, he said, I want this for my child, or for my grandchild. So he went over to the Motel, and he said, I want this boy. She said, I'm sorry, he's taken already. I can't take him. She said, who? You're talking about the Baruch. The Baruch, the Baruch. So he said, the kids of the Baruch, impressed on the Motel that he has to ask his father. Now the Motel would only go to the tzion of his father once a year. Otherwise, with Tech Bittel, he didn't feel right to go to the tzion of his father. But since the Baruch made such an impression on him, so he decided he's going to go. He came back with a message. The message is that the Baruch is half a grace. But there should have been la'ela mikul v'chulsa. This is hechel from all the Baruchs. And if that's the case, you're not going to battle the Shidduch, and they continue. Who was this child? As far as I understand, this was a Yaakov Yisrael Shekhasa, who married the daughter of the Mitzvah, who was the grandparents of Yerushalayim Shtemes Sarah, who was the mother of the Fidei Rebbe. So this is why the Shemashmid was trying to tell the Fidei Rebbe, it's Negev to you. He was trying to tell the Fidei Rebbe, it's Negev to you. You are a product of this Yichud, of this Shidduch. listening here to Pastor Ray here. That is my design, we have the guest speaker here. I'm sure it's going to be Myers, but the kids are here, and we have this Pasha, Bikish Yakib Legalis is a case. And the Rebbe translates the word Bikish, that we should be Mavakish Yakib Legalis the case, and it should be taken from the Avramish.
At the end of the story, drunk.